Check 1, 2. Check.
All right. This morning, we have got for you guys the chapel theme of The Road Less Traveled. And so how apropos we should begin by a poem of very similar name, The Road Not Taken, by Robert Frost, which goes a little something like this. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. I'm sorry I could not travel both and be one traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other, as just as fair and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I should be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. And two roads diverged in a road and wood. And I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. You don't have to applaud. It's okay. I think this ties in very well with our theme of the year in Matthew 7, which speaks of the narrow road and few find it. The thing I note about this poem and the narrow road in Matthew 7 is that there's no guarantee that though it makes a difference, it's going to be easier. There's no guarantee that it's going to be more prosperous as the world measures prosperity. But it does make a difference, a meaningful and a lasting difference. And it might cost you the sacrifice of popularity. It might cost you the sacrifice of friends. But in the end, the difference that he makes is an eternal one, and it's worth it. And that's what Robert Frost captured here, and that's what Matthew captured there. So enjoy the rest of today's chapel.
Thank you.
right, so one more this morning. The Yiddy band is going to finish off with a song called She Loves You by the Beatles, but because this is chapel, we're going to change it to He Loves You. Okay? Here we go. One, three, one, two, three.
About all those people. Can anyone think? They were young. Thank you. All right, so in that video, you saw that all of those people, they were basically kids. I mean, most of the time when you think about people in the Bible, you think, oh, they're like a million, probably, when the Lord works in their life. But when you see that video, it's true. Like, the Lord can work in anyone. And that's why it's so important to start following the narrow path when you're young, because then, like, you have so many more opportunities to see the Lord work in your life. And, you know, He'll do glorious things for your life. So this first song that we're going to sing is called Everything Glorious. So if you would stand up and sing it with us, that you can worship with us.
I'm about to rap a song. It's about our theme verse, about the narrow gate. So if you got that beat, just drop it whenever. Yeah. Let's go. Let's get it. Yeah. Let's go. We got it. OCS right now. Faith in beginners, beginners in faith. Faith in beginners, beginners in faith. Faith in beginners, beginners in faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Faith in beginners, beginners in faith. Faith in beginners, beginners in faith. Faith in beginners, beginners in faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Matthew 7, I'm straight through heaven. Open up your eyes. Jesus is risen. Every single thing that I've ever had doesn't match your love or the narrow path. If you take the gate that is very wide, open up inside, it'll take life. God is good. God is great. Better than an Instagram TBH rate. Gotta focus on what really matters. matters. Life is like a glass until it shatters. Go now to take the narrow eternal gate, 'cause before you know it, it is too late. Faith and beginners, beginners and faith. Faith and beginners, beginners and faith. Faith and beginners, beginners and faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Faith and beginners, beginners and faith. Faith and beginners, beginners and faith. Faith and beginners, beginners and faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Ooh. Faith of beginners, beginners of faith. I don't regret granted that God is so great. I never let the demons into my soul. With all my heart, I will never let go. Hey, hey. Faith, 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 faith. Every ounce of self in the temptation to spoil your heart on creating integration with all of your heart and your mind and your soul. Just pray to God to never let go. The wagon is Satan's bait to humanity. If you take it, you will lose your sanity. Oh, man, we're getting the words already. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So what's your choice? Shouldn't it be clear? I think I've made it very sincere. So let me finish with some bars just to make it clear. Everything influences by society. Just open your eyes and take more propriety. Why get is evil as far as I can say? You say it is not, then you apply to me. Why get is the path of a lunacy? Why get is totally ludicrous? Lurking the devil is totally ludicrous. So wait up. Wait one more time, we're gonna sing it. Wait, did the beat go up? Beginners in faith, faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Faith of beginners, beginners in faith. Open your eyes, take the narrow gate. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, faith of beginners, faith of beginners, beginners of faith. Faith of beginners, beginners of faith. Yeah. Think we're done here. Faith of beginners.
All right. Okay. So, this is a song that I wrote, and it's called Talking to the Lord. And over the past year or so, I learned a lot, and I went through a lot of things. But each hard time that I went through, I learned a very valuable lesson about the Lord. So I wrote a song about it, and yeah. So yeah, the song is called Talking to the Lord. By the darkness and the sounds, wanting to find out if everlasting love can be found. I wished on a wishing star I'd find out why we're here, why we're made. Is there such thing as grace? Who's the God and what's his name? Set me free, and that was the first time. Yeah, that was the first time I was talking to the Lord. Confused by mercy and caught up in regret. As the days got longer and loving got tougher, and there was no sight of a helping hand. And one night I lost it as yelling filled the room. And somehow I know, no, it's not the good Lord's fault, but I was tired of being good and strong. And I yelled, wherever you are, can you tell me why? 'Cause I'm begging you please, and I'm having a rough time. Then like a wave over me, you said it's not easy. Life's a wild ride, and that's what I learned when I was talking to the Lord my God, the one and only, the one whose name is holy. Like a wave over me, you knew just what I need and gave me Psalm 69. And that's what I learned when I was talking to the Lord. Talking to the Lord. Yeah.
Two paths, two gates, one decision. A choice that's made with much precision. You look at one and it's appearing fun, it's standing tall and wide. But once you enter, you're on the road to sins, cheats, and lies. Along the way is destruction and damage. After the brokenness, how will you manage? You turn away and look at another. The gate is narrow and different from the other. It looks scary and all of it's new, but in your heart, it's the right thing to do. Two paths, two gates, one decision. Have you made your choice? Was it made with precision? It's your decision. God made you to choose. But you picked the wrong one and you're left with a bruise. So the next time you decide to sin and do wrong, think about the gates and think of them long. Think of how one deceives you with looks and it's just chaos as the gate unhooks. And the other is narrow, but it almost feels nice. When God opens the door, he doesn't think twice. Two paths, two gates, one decision. Will you be the person who thinks with precision?
Light shine bright like the moon in the night, as this kingdom is real. Don't ever be deceived, but take God whom you've received. Jesus, take the wheel. Take the road of the narrow path, release the load of your own wrath. Before him, sin shall kneel. As our mentor, our captain, king of the world we're trapped in, Jesus, take the wheel. He has provided us with strength and a mind beyond length. He fills our hearts with zeal. There is no other way. Without God, our souls will pay. Jesus, take the wheel. We are jealous, we are neutral, yet we're commanded to be fruitful. Lord, come to us to heal. As we round up our ranks, instead of Christ, we use tanks. Jesus, take the wheel. Our will is scarred, we are broken. We need the word that you have spoken. Your power is truly surreal. Your love is deeper than an ocean and can fix this commotion. Jesus, never look back towards the needles and necks. Lord, to our senses you appeal. Your way is difficult, and it is not typical. But Jesus, take the wheel.
When I awoke, I saw two roads and I saw one was wide and the other narrow. I could not turn back now that I was here. So I knew that this choice was mine to make. Would I walk the narrow and painful road, or take the easy way out on the wide? The narrow road led to a paradise, but so many hardships were in the way. I considered taking the wide, quick path, even though certain death was at the end. This dilemma I pondered for a while, until my decision was made and done. Now these two roads diverge in front of you. Which path of life will you follow, sir?
There are choices, paths in life that we must choose to follow. We all have free will, so this is our choice. We hear from all directions which way to go. We must choose carefully the correct path. Some of us want to start on the easy path, the wide road. Others we know are traveling, and it was easy. But I decided on the narrow gate. The traffic is light on the narrow path. It's rugged and rocky. One may ask, why do I travel this narrow road? I go down it because I will find pure peace and joy. With each step on this narrow path, I realize that it is worth it. The wide road brings sadness and despair. I don't travel down the narrow road alone. I have a guide that will help me find the way. You may stumble and fall, but if you keep your eyes on the guide, you will find your way again. Obstacles along this journey will be fear, pain, insecurities, jealousy, and hatred, but we must learn to overcome them. Along the journey, others may stumble and fall, but always be willing to reach down to pick them up. To make this journey, you will need the help of others, and you will need to be willing to look for those who have fallen. The prize at the end of this journey is far better than a blue ribbon, gold medal, or sum of money. For the reward at the end of this journey is to have everlasting life in God's presence.
I cast my eyes down, tears dripping, down, down, down. I sink deeper and deeper into the ground. I look up. I run my hands on the wood. Up, up, up. My eyes are opened. My head is held up. The weight of the world is gone. I am set free.